Welcome back to Razmafzar TV. I'm really happy to tell you and to announce that my new book is published. This is called Jewels and Patterned Crucible Steel, Book of Jewels, Stones, and Metals. This is this book, and in Nilufar Books, where my last two books of mine are published here. And what is this book all about? In this book, I provide a complete translation and also annotation of a book called Goharnāmeh, the Book of Jewels or the Book of Gems by Ben Mansur. Regarding this book, I really need to say, I mean, the reason I chose the translation Jewels, Gohar, is the exact translation, not gems, because Gohar is used in this book, not only to refer to precious stones, but also to semi-precious stones, in our today's understanding, and also metals such as gold, silver, and alloys as well, like bronze and copper. I mean, bronze, of course, we know is a copper alloy, and metals in general, and among them, iron and steel, because this book also talks about patterned crucible steel and the classification of it. This is an extremely important thing to take into consideration, because we need to understand that it's 9th century hijra, right? This book and 15th century common era, that's where the original one was written. And you will be very surprised to see that this book provides a very, very detailed and surprisingly exact description of all these jewels, stones, precious stones, semi-precious stones, metals. The book is not only about this translation, annotation of the book. The first part of the book, I am going to talk about, every stone and precious stones which the book talks about, and then talk about the modern scientific description of that, then compare it to what the book talks about. So there is a comparison made between the two. And there are also some beautiful pictures of gems provided, right, in the book, which I'm going to show to you now. And this is also, and you will be surprised to see that. And also the book talks as well, in this book, also talk about some animal products, right? Bezoars, right, back then, and corals, and many of these type of animal stones, and among them also pearls. So let me just show part of the book to you. So it is the book. I have some samples here. I mean, still in shrink package and plastic. So I'm going to take one of it. As you can see, it's a full color book. It's not only on the jacket, but also inside. And that's a really good quality. I'll print it in Germany as well. It's a German quality book. And I'm going to open it for you. So to get the shrink plastic away. So just be a bit careful. So this is what I'm going to open it. Everything is also, you can take a look at that. Now, so I'm going to open it so we can take a look at it. It starts here, Jewels and Patterned Crucible Steel, Book of Jewels, Stones and Metals. So it's an introduction, and after this introduction about different types of what Goharnāmeh books are about, and in historical context, this one compared to the other one. Here you see one page of the original one, and here you see different precious stones and also semi-precious stones depicted, all of them here in this part I describe and put it in, first of all, scientific description of each precious stone, semi-precious stones, animal products, and then I compare it to what this manuscript of Goharnāmeh by Ben Mansur talks about that. So that makes it interesting to have a comparison between the understanding of these stones compared to our scientific understanding of us, and here the part on metal, start gold, silver, copper alloys, and tin as well. And you can take a look at it. There are some antique coins made of silver and gold are depicted as well, parts of swords having these metals inside. And here you can see it here that the manuscript starts, so it's fully translated and annotated, so you can follow all my translations and annotations and descriptions here to get a better understanding of all these things. And you cannot separate jewel steel from other jewels. And here there are Canary Islands, because it gives also information on local geographical information, and compare them, measure them always to the distance to Canary Islands. Here there is a Sasanid sword, and here you see Persian Shamshir. They're all exceptional quality ones from different private collections in Europe, and some of them from Iran, mostly from Europe. All from private collections, as you can see it here, and I showed you, of course, I just showed some of them. Well, I have shown some parts of my new book, and I really hope you have enjoyed it. This book is very important because, as you can see, patterned crucible steel is also considered clearly in this book, next to precious stones, semi-precious stones, and also metals and animal products like pearls, something precious. Jewel steel is the exact translation of Pulad-e Gohardar, or patterned crucible steel. So it was considered like that. In my book, I also show many different, books precious stones, and also describe, as I have shown it before, describe all these items to you. This book shows also very good examples of swords, sabers from Iran, from India, from Ottoman Empire, and also exceptional daggers from these countries. So you can take a look at them. They're really, really beautiful. I hope that you have enjoyed this book presentation. If you want to order this book, it's as usual sold on our web shop, and you can go and buy it and order it there. Thank you very much. And just the last point, this year, another book of mine is going to be published. I'm going to follow the same line about different types of Goharnameh and Persian manuscripts to have real information from the source, from the real source, about swords, about arms and armor in as described in Persian manuscripts. So stay tuned, and thank you very much. Have a nice day.